There are 83 million mobile phone subscriptions in the UK. That's more than one for each person. And it certainly means that one hazard of modern life is that of damaging a mobile handset accidentally. Well, our next entrepreneur believes he has a solution.
Hi, my name's Oliver Murphy, and I'm here today looking for an investment of £50,000 for a 15% equity stake in my company, Reviveaphone, a repair kit for water-damaged phones. The reason I started the company was after seeing on Twitter there was a post every minute about someone damaging their phone with water, losing all of their emails, important contacts, and all their personal photos. I'll now show you how easy it is to use the repair kit. Remove the phone from the water and turn off immediately. The quicker you can turn the phone off, the more chance you have of repairing your phone. Carefully cut the top of the pouch with scissors. Place the phone inside with the Reviveaphone solution for 7 minutes. Seal it up and leave. Remove the phone and dispose of the Reviveaphone solution. Place the phone back into the pouch with a super dry sachet for 24 hours. Once the 24 hours is up, remove the phone from the pouch and power up the device. It should be fully restored. I have so far had a high success rate with the kit, selling 1,300 in the first 10 months of trading. With it from a £400 startup cost, I have turned over £20,000 and taken a net profit of £3,000. Thank you for listening. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
An intriguing pitch from Oliver Murphy, whose product demonstration certainly appears to have caught Deborah Meaden's eye.
Oliver, I feel like I've been watching a magic show. that's amazing.
If only I'd had that about a month ago when I did exactly that thing, which was drop my phone, and I've had to transfer everything. Like I say, it looks like magic to me, but I'm sure it's not.
It's not as much magic as it seems. Basically, I wanted to fix water-damaged phones, and I decided that I'd investigate a bit more and see what caused the damage. It's not actually the fluid itself that creates the damage; it's the contents of the water, because water isn't pure, so it's the minerals attaching themselves to the phone's components.
When I was at my villa a couple of months ago, and I jumped in the pool with my phone in my pocket, and I got out of the pool. I dismantled my phone and left it on the side to dry in the sun. Was that a stupid thing to do?
If it didn't work at all, there's a chance it would have short-circuited by trying to... you obviously tried to turn it on afterwards.
It came back on, but it just did silly things.
Yeah. But those connections need to be cleared.
But you're putting it in another fluid, is that right?
Yes, that is right.
So you are literally... That solution is literally washing away...
It cleans away the minerals and excess, whatever's in the water.
How big is your market? How many people are dropping phones in the toilet or jumping into the pool like Duncan likes to do?
There's lots of facts around saying 10% of people damage their phone with water, and they say in the UK there's been 860,000 a drop down the loo a year. And for instance, on Twitter, there's constant posts about people damaging their phones with water or iPods with water.
I think you've created a great product.
Thanks.
And I'd respectfully ask that all four dragons immediately say that they're out so that I can continue a negotiation with you.
Absolutely not.
Is that because you're trying to get it cheaper?
Peter Jones isn't the only one in the den with a sharp eye for a deal. The generous margin on Oliver's phone repair kits has made the dragons eager to find out more about their manufacture.
Where are you getting them made?
I make them myself.
Oh, right. Yes.
So you're at home and you're in a room somewhere with a big bucket full of chemicals and these pouches tipping in there in plastic gloves?
In my mum's utility room, so.
Is there a whole world out there who repair water-damaged phones?
There are say, repair services that can repair phones, but it's a bit more inconvenient going to the repair store, and you need to trust them, obviously, with your expensive phone.
If you're a phone repairer, it's your business. Do you know? Is this how they fix water-damaged phones?
That, yes.
So you made a consumer.
A consumer product, right, yes.
Okay. I think you're great. I think you've got huge potential. I might be mad, but I'm going to make you an offer. For the full amount, for 25%.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, what could you bring to help?
I'm sure that I can get this into big supermarket chains and other stores around the world. And I can also bring fantastic PR to the table and get it out there. And I know I'm asking for more of a percentage, and you might decide today that you just want to go away and you can do it on your own.
I don't know what to do. Would you be able to come down to 20% at all?
No.
I think I'd like to accept.
Yay!
Thank you.
So now I'll go and drop my phone down the loo and see if it works.
Well done.
Thank you.
So, a positive result for Oliver, who leaves the den with £50,000 and a promise of the backing needed to potentially crack the high street.
I did think I was going for all of them at one point, and I was hoping for Peter Jones, and I didn't really know much about Kelly, so I was a bit, am I happy, am I not? And I didn't really know, but yeah, no, it all went well, so I'm very happy.
Well done, Kelly.
Yeah, good one there, Kelly.
I like him.
Well,
he's great.
He's a smart, great guy to invest in.
Yeah.
I better get on with that idea quick then.
You bloody dare.